put up the picture of the retired lieutenant who decided to shoot and kill a DC cop. Let me give you background to this. You're looking at 58-year-old ex-officer Jesse Porter. Jesse Porter, who conducted training courses for officers as a private contractor. Okay, let's put up the picture of a 25-year-old woman. Okay, her name is Maurica Manyan, a special police officer and mother of a 4-year-old son who was shot dead. Here's what happened. The shooting of this special police officer during a baton training exercise at a DC library came as the group of trainees had gathered to take a picture and were joking around. According to court documents, this young lady, 25 years of age, interrupted the picture taking to remove her face mask. Her classmates teased her, and then the instructor, let's put his picture back up quickly. The instructor, 58-year-old Jesse Porter, pulled his gun from his holster and shot her in the chest. That's according to surveillance video of the incident described in the documents. Now, what happened after this? The 25-year-old female officer was rushed to the hospital where she later was pronounced dead. She had been on the force for less than a year. Sources say that Porter mistakenly drew a pistol instead of a prop gun to illustrate how quickly it could be done and accidentally fired the shot. Witnesses said Porter had a brightly colored training gun, a replica, in his holster until the time of the shooting. Metropolitan Police Chief Robert Conti said it was unclear why Porter had live ammunition in his gun during the damn training exercise, which was against protocol. Okay? After Porter discharged the gun, a witness reported him asking, "I thought I had my training gun," Porter told the first police officer who responded to the library on Thursday afternoon. "Why did I do this? Is she okay?" "Oh, she's not okay. Sir, you shot in the chest." All right? Jesse Porter, 58, has now been charged with one count of involuntary manslaughter, one count of negligence while holding a loaded firearm in the death of the officer. And put up his picture again, because I'm going to remind you of something. You do realize that there are multiple cops right now who are free. And they said, "Oh my goodness, I accidentally discharged my firearm. I thought I had a taser." Okay? These cops shot unarmed black people in the back typically, or unarmed black people who were actually in handcuffs. And they claim, "Oh my goodness, I thought I had my taser." Well, they didn't get arrested. Many of them faced no justice whatsoever. It was classified, categorized as an on-duty mistake. Unfortunate, brutal, sad, but not criminal. However, they figured out a way to lock his black ass up quickly. Don't think for one moment that him being African American played no weight on him going to jail immediately after this shooting. He said it was an accident. It may have been an accident. I doubt it. Even if it is an accident, it's gross negligence, which means if you didn't have the intent, you knew good and damn well, sir, that all of the protocols you violated could have led to injury or death of somebody there. That's why these protocols are in place. Now, this woman was a new mother. This woman had a bright career in front of her. And based on every narrative available, she was one of the good ones. She was a good cop who's now dead. All right.
Yeah, I mean, there's so many stories over the past year where like there's like so many different training incidents where there are problems. I mean, literally like, I forgot his name and this is really, really terrible. But like in Minneapolis, the person who was killed for having a like green like air freshener in his car was killed during a training run. And there's so many instances where stuff like this happens during training where these police officers are just incredibly reckless. And to me, it speaks to really teaching people to be reckless. Because in most other countries where police officers do have firearms, typically they will have to call in to some sort of central office to say that they're using a firearm and explain why. And the reason for that is really simple, because it's actually dangerous to just have firearms laying around. And even if you're doing training, there needs to be strict protocols so that accidents don't happen, because we realize that with firearms, the risk is so grave. And ultimately, it is just like shameful that the United States is so cavalier with guns. The mentality of treating guns like toys is very pervasive within not only the general society of the United States, but also the police forces. And it puts people in these dangerous situations where, you know, this police officer can claim that this situation was an accident. It seems like a really weird and specific accident, because it wasn't even like an exercise where they weren't even in the middle of like an exercise that should have had guns. It seemed like they were like in a moment of taking a picture, and it was just, everything about this is just like very, very strange, and it's just deeply, deeply upsetting.
It's at least gross negligence, which is criminal, at least that, if nothing else. And listen, at this point, we have police officers being from all over the country. They now get in touch with us at Indisputable, trying to highlight corruption in their own police department. I have multiple cases that I'm working right now to expose. And I try to highlight a dynamic here, especially for police officers who are people of color, for police officers who are women. This industry, they don't give a damn about you. They really don't. And until you stand up and transform the culture, this kind of anti-blackness will continue to permeate. You can't believe that just because you put on that blue uniform that somehow you're now part of the white supremacy power structure. You are not. They tolerate you. They allow you to remain for a period of time. But I guarantee you, when the rubber hits the road, you will be treated differently as well. So you need to always be aware of that. I do these pieces to highlight, contrast, and provide education to the industry that cops are a part of, because we got some good people in policing. They simply have to get in positions of leadership, or you got to get out of it and become an active critic in order for that industry to survive.